What a closing ceremony. What spectacle, what artistry. What inflatables. Getting his first taste of what the world can expect from the 2000 games, Juan Antonio Samaranch said, maybe Sydney wasn't such a good idea. But now the pressure is on to decide exactly which inflatable creatures we'll use at our opening ceremony. The general consensus seems to be blowing up Arthur Tunstall. And did we all have fun filling out our census forms? Yeah? My favourite part was question 18. How well does the person speak English? One of the answers was not at all. Now, if you're ticking not at all, how did you even get to question 18? Census results are used to allocate government resources. I overestimated the number of people who stayed in my house on Tuesday night. So now they're going to build a hospital in my backyard. The Indonesian military claims the Australian Labor Party may have funded the pro-democracy group accused of starting the recent riots in Jakarta. In a counter-accusation, the ALP claims the Liberals give money to the Indonesian government so they won't laugh whenever they get a visit from Alexander Downer. L-plate drivers will soon have to fill in a logbook proving they can drive in a variety of conditions before they get a licence. Is it just me, or does the idea of a learner doing his first 100 in a 60 zone while making a note in his logbook sound a little dangerous? The good news is that unemployed learners can actually combine the logbook with the doll diary. So when they list the conditions they've driven under, they can include poor and depressed. The ALP is completely reassessing its platform and will draft a more streamlined version to take it to the next election. They're responding to a survey that found Labor isn't held in very high regard. That survey was called the 1996 federal election. And in worrying news, banks are increasing fees and charges after a commission designed to monitor them was abandoned. Even bank robbers are going to be hit with extra charges. $6 for a hostage to get down on the floor, $8 for a manager to open the safe, and $2 per screen per teller. You can still shoot at staff for free. The banks are trying to get rid of them anyway. Now, if you're at a loose end tomorrow, why not visit Open Day at the Lodge in Yarralumla? I mean, win a great prize at the Toss Oysters into Tim Fisher's mouth stand. And don't miss the beautiful Lodge Gardens, which have been remodeled along coalition lines. They've gotten rid of anything labour-intensive, cut back the natives, and given all the best positions to the vegetables. And that's the good news. Thank you, and welcome to Good News Week. Please welcome our first team tonight, Captain Mikey Robbins, Triple J's breakfast goddess, Helen Razer, and Sydney Morning Herald heartthrob journo, Tony Squires. And their noble opponents, Commander Julie McCrossan, and two of Australia's best comedians, James O'Loughlin and Peter Berner. Round one, Mikey, Helen and Tony. Yep. What's the story?
Australian Olympic team arriving home.
Yeah, that's the throw Arthur Tunstall from a helicopter competition. That's one of my favourites, actually.
Congratulating the dream team.
Post-diet.
Hasn't Billy trimmed down for the election?
He certainly has. He's soup-like.
And that's a bloke who can't get a date kissing a flag. Which is sad.
I think is happening there is that the world community was pretty anti Karadzic, I think the man's name is pronounced, in the Bosnian elections, and that was Billy Clinton saying, well, he shouldn't be allowed to, in fact, be involved in a vote because he's a world war criminal.
And the soldiers would represent either alleged US intervention or
bloody good US intervention, which didn't get him.
That's right. They want him to stand aside. He didn't. He did some kind of weird maneuver and didn't really stand aside for the election. He still has the power, I think, is essentially the story.
You got it all in there together. There's bits of answer all over the place. I'm going to give you two because I'm feeling generous at the moment.
Yes.
Yeah. A British newspaper claims the US is planning a commando raid to kidnap Bosnian Serb leader Radovan Karadzic, still wanted for war crimes. If all goes according to plan, several commandos will arrest Karadzic after a pinpoint parachute drop into his hair. Julie, James and Peter, what's going on here?
Oh, all the same thing.
More military, the same thing.
Australia's most eligible bachelor competition.
Yeah, man of the year.
And there's a lot of concern at the moment that in the budget there could be a cut to labour market programs, but this is proof that the coalition federal government at the moment is utterly committed to creating jobs by airlifting in thousands of American officers, soldiers, to work with our people intimately, constantly.
We're sucking up to the US again.
it's nostalgia. It's the good old times back.
We haven't had a decent dose of the clap in this country since the 40s, you know?
Australia's taken a backward step in reintroducing military, close military links with the US, and if that offends this country's leaders, well, what can they do? They've already cut the funding.
An emotional but honest answer there, James.
Who cares?
I'm going to give you two because you do care. Thousands of Australian and American troops will take part in Operation Tandem Thrust. A what? Massive military exercise.
I've got a video that specialises in that. It's from Canberra.
That's random thrust, eh?
All right.
Tandem Thrust is a military exercise which will occur in Queensland next year. And it should be a lot of fun, especially if the current war games in the Northern Territory are any indication, where two US fighters almost collided with a passenger jet. The good news is the incident gave the war games that one element of reality that was missing, the chance to accidentally kill civilians. Strange but true. Part one, three clues now, and tales will be told later. Before the show, Mikey's team were given a pair of clogs.
Yep, those are clogs.
A speeding ticket.
A legitimate infringement notice.
Yeah.
And a sheep.
Yeah.
It looks like something you'd buff your shoes with, doesn't
it? Yeah, it does indeed.
Fairly overt symbolism here with the clogs. You'd have to say the Netherlands.
No, it's actually an Amish shoe phone.
Get smart and goff. And Julie's team, you got the Virgin Mary, 10,000 buckets of water.
Funding cuts.
And look at this for ABC Art Department. Hey, a fractured skull.
Hey. Be careful, Tim Fisher wants that back.
We are so much better dressed than you lot.
I got to admit, on the dress stakes, you know. Whoa!
And you could have worn a nice frock.
Like a peasant shirt, very glebe.
Thanks. Someone nicked my collar. Well, did you guys get private sponsorship or something?
Oh, too sad.
Just banter about clothing for a bit longer. Round two starts with bikes. Helen, what is acting New South Wales Premier Andrew F. Shorgi waxing lyrical about here?
We are saying that the prize that we have here, this glory we have here, is part of world significance.
I'd say it'd have to be the Planet Hollywood opening, really. conceivably the Olympics. Perhaps?
The old Homebush Bay, the site, the...
Did you see what was behind him there?
Oh, Opera House.
Whoop.
Some concrete steps.
Yeah, his place.
He loves concrete.
He's just put a new pool and he said, oh, I'm going to take him out there. They can do a couple of laps in the dry clad. We're proud of it.
You've got no idea? Was mentioned before?
Yeah, Olympic facilities.
No, you're all wrong. Forget it. Anyone. I don't care anymore. Anyone from the audience?
Opera House.
I said Opera House, you monkey.
He said Opera House.
Run the tape back. The fat guy said Opera House.
You said Opera House. Helen's question.
We're sharing.
We're sharing.
We have a symbiotic relationship,
okay.
All right?
What are you, an only child?
You can put a guy in a suit, Mikey, but...
It's the Opera House. The New South Wales government wants the Sydney Opera House listed as a World Heritage Site.
That'd be stupid.
Well, it would be, because only four other man-made structures have been listed this century.
Synthetic
and really...
structures. Sexist language, Paul.
Yes.
Yes.
A couple of weak, wristed, no hope, couldn't put a painting in a gallery if they tried. Women probably didn't do a thing to make any of the great structures man has on this planet.
You impotent little anti-feminist! You take that back!
You show me one shot of a woman lifting a tile onto the opera house and I'll give you 20 points.
Mind you, though, we do have thousands of shots of women jiffing the side of it clean.
No points. But only four other synthetic structures have been listed this century. And really, what chance does the Opera House have when they've already knocked back Michael Jackson's nose and Ray Martin's hair? James, your bite from the exceedingly high-profile Minister for Veteran Affairs, Bruce Scott.
Oh, I think it's significant in the history of this nation that we are going, and it certainly is part of that healing process.
We've never seen that man before in our life.
Sounds like he kept getting one of his wounds stitched up. I think it's about Australians going back to celebrate the anniversary of a war in Nam. And I was reminded of Nam, obviously, when the choppers were on the other clips. But yeah, wouldn't you think if you'd been in a battle, though, 25 years ago, and they said, oh, great, go back and celebrate it, you just go, oh, piss off, mate. I'll stay here under the bed, thanks.
A beautiful 1 point. 1 point, a well-deserved 1 point. A delegation of 30 Australian veterans and war widows will visit Vietnam to commemorate the 30th anniversary of the Battle of Long Tan. They had some trouble making up the numbers for the visit until the government conscripted several participants who really didn't want to go. Second game is the usual suspects. Mikey, we want you to link these people and complete the lineup. Your suspects are? Jesus of Nazareth.
I was the guy from Soundgarden.
Buddha.
Yeah.
And Eric Clapton.
Oh, it's obvious.
Who's number four?
Jesus played a Strat. Buddha played a Gibson Les Paul. they're all deities. Some people refer to Jesus as God. Some people regard Buddha as pretty good in the God stakes. Eric Clapton was known as God, which only leaves Gary Ablett! Why am I saying that? I'm a Swans fan. It's Gary Ablett. He's the other God in the pack.
You're right. It's Gary Ablett.
All right.
AFL God Gary Ablett, Cardinal Carlo Martini, the man tipped to be the next Pope, says it's not blasphemous for fans to call Ablett God, as long as you don't call God the full forward from Geelong. Julie, who's the missing suspect here? We have Bergen Wills, Liz Hiddens, the Bush Tucker man, Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. Who's number four?
Well, we've got a desert theme, we've got an outback theme.
And they've got fuzzy hair by them.
Brian Johns.
Could be a wilderness story. Look, I think the little lass who married into the royal family and has recently left, young Fergie...
Is she going to be the next Bush Tucker woman?
Bush Tucker woman, showing the survival skills of the British. So the essential theme is people wearing odd costumes, period costumes, over-the-top Aussie costumes, dresses, and then British fashion nonsense into the desert. That'd be Fergie.
Fergie, you are right. Fergie. She's going to Dresden to host a documentary, and people have questioned the bizarre choice of Fergie hosting a documentary about the Maralinga tests and Aboriginal culture. But she says she's always had a strong belief in getting paid to do stuff. Fergie says the devastation at Maralinga is terrible. There are no trees, no grass. It's just like a desert. Spot the Bull is the last game. Only one of these statements was actually said, but which one? Tony, some words of wisdom now from that erudite shooter, Ian McNiven. Listen, when Indonesian soldiers slaughter your kiddies in their beds, don't come crying to me. Our recommendation to people, patriotic Australians, is to bury early and to bury often. Or was it three? I'm not going to admit to having a gun that could blow a hole right through Jackboot Johnny's bulletproof vest. A man's not a bloody idiot.
Yeah.
The sad thing is they're all quite feasible.
Well, they
really
are, really, although there seem to be too many words consecutively for them to be in at all, really. A dinner party with he and Artie Tunstall would be a really top-notch affair, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it'd be top fun.
It would be. Look, it could be the second one with the burying the guns, but...
I'd bury that shirt if I was him. I'd bury that shirt deep.
Exactly. But I equate Ian with ugly, and the first one is definitely the ugliest, so I'm going to go number one.
I'm going to toss it over here. What number is it?
I reckon it's three, isn't it?
It's number two, actually.
Let's roll the tape.
Our recommendation to people, patriotic Australians, is to bury early and bury often.
He's not talking about Nana. I mean, you only bury her once. Yeah, I'm going to dig her up and bury her again. What the hell?
At least this will permanently reduce the number of guns in the community. Most of McNiven's supporters are too stupid to remember where they buried them. Ian actually got the idea from watching his dog with a bone. He also advised shooters to urinate on trees to mark their territory and to drink out of the toilet. Peter, yes. What did Ian Turpey, entertainer, really say?
I like Terps.
One is, I wouldn't say I was washed up, but from where I was, I could certainly see the rocks. Number two is, host Wheel of Fortune, not when I can sing in the club every week. And number three, yep, I'm a little bit disappointed because I'm to the right of Genghis Khan.
It's the third one, mate, because, you know, obviously he's to the right of Genghis Khan.
And he'd be at the ABC rally to support the ABC in Sydney, and he was saying that he voted for the coalition and he's that disappointed. He's right of Genghis Khan, but he's not happy with what's going on.
You're right, and one very proud, powerful point.
Yeah, I'm a little bit disappointed because I'm to the right of Genghis Khan.
Genghis Khan is actually very misunderstood.
He was actually very much an environmentalist.
He only cut down people.
What a team.
Yeah, but they're dressed like Nirvana.
Oh, thanks, Courtney.
I'm getting vicious, this one. Ian's older than he looks. When he says it's the right of Genghis Khan, he means in the school photo. Actually, Genghis Khan would be better for the ABC than the coalition. I mean, they both have the same rape and pillage mentality, but at least Genghis knew where he was going. Checking the scores now, Mikey, Helen and Tony can't hit the high notes on a miserable 3 points. While Julie James and Peter can't complain on a rampaging 5 points. Yeah. The game now is face value. James, who is behind this disguise?
Oh, here we go.
It's one of those blow-up kangaroos.
Oh, no, it's obviously Alexander Downer.
No, it's disguise.
Throw it over here.
Jimmy Barnes?
Jimmy Barnes?
What?
What?
I can see sort of a little bit of a hair down there.
There's a real ear as a clue.
Oh, that narrows it down. Someone who owns an ear.
Van Gogh before the cut.
Let's take away a piece of the disguise.
Yep, it's obviously, gosh, it's the giveaway now.
Okay.
It is.
It is Arthur Tunstall.
Anyone?
Obviously an old person.
Okay, let's take away another piece of the disguise.
It's the old gymnast beside him.
It's Ronald Reagan.
He said it.
Ronald Reagan?
What do you mean he said it, but he's
right? Andy's right.
Ronald Reagan.
Grandpa Simpson.
Okay, let's take away one last piece of the disguise.
Yeah, it's,
Thank you.
Oh, yes.
Was, of course, Rupert Murdoch. John Howard says he isn't going to let any alleged Murdoch-Packer alliance affect his media ownership policy. They can beg and threaten all they like, but he's still going to let them do whatever they want. Tony, Helen and Mikey, who's the odd one out here?
Yep.
And why?
We
have the Indonesian security police.
Mm-hmm.
Optus.
Yep.
The gay Mardi Gras.
Yep.
And Mr. Whippy.
Is it the, secret police, because they're the only ones you can't hear coming.
That's good.
That's very nice. We like that one.
From an eminently personal perspective, I'd say the gay and lesbian Mardi Gras is the odd one out because they're the only people I'd want in my suburb.
Good point.
Exactly. There was the thing about soft serve ice cream being bad for you, and Mr. Whippy, I think, was mentioned in that report.
And there were no soft serves on Mardi Gras night.
No. Getting very close. I'm going to give you 2 points for the first answer. It is Mr. Whippy.
Oh, right.
How so?
Mr. Whippy, because no one gets really upset when he comes down their street.
Depends how you know, Mr. Whippy.
Absolutely.
Which Mr. Whippy are we actually talking about?
Mr. Whippy.
Peter, James and Julie, who's the diamond in the rough here? We have the corpse plant. A cannabis plant.
Oh, is that what they look like?
And Mr. Naivety. A nuclear plant. And Don Burke.
Ah.
Well, we're talking smell and we're talking danger.
They're all overpriced. Especially Don.
Yeah, they've all got a decent head on them, except... nuclear plant.
In fact, is Don the only one without the word plant in his name? Power plant, marijuana plant.
Well spotted.
Yeah.
Corpse plant only comes out every 33 years and the rest of them are perennials.
I'm going to give you 1 point.
Because we tried so hard.
Because you did, and for a long time. Yeah. It's the cannabis plant, because people will stick around if they know it's in your backyard. The corpse flower has just bloomed for the first time in 30 years at London's Kew Gardens. Its aroma has been described as a combination of rotting fish and rotting flesh. This is because it doesn't want to attract bees. It wants to attract morgue attendants, who pollinate it as they rifle through its pockets. Mikey, Helen and Tony are cutting the mustard now on a very powerful 5 points. While Julie, James and Peter cut the cheese on 7 points. Thought Bubble is the name of our bonus round. 3 points to the best line or caption for this photograph. Team Julie, you go first tonight.
Someone said, Mr. Costello, how big's your heart?
Ooh, and social comment.
The ABC will have about this much money left.
Anyone from Mikey's team?
Compared to the height of the Empire State Building, this amount of people will actually be able to afford university degrees?
Treasurer demonstrates how he holds Prime Minister and dries him after his bath.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm sorry, it goes to Mikey. A well-told, strange but true story could still get to you 5 points. So it's anyone's game at this point. Let's make all these ones good, boys and girls. Mikey, Helen and Tony, your clues were... a pair of clogs, speeding ticket...
yep.
And a sheep.
It's actually Dutch Nikes. How many medals they get? If you dance fast enough, you will start fire.
Poignant semiotics obviously points to the fact that this event occurred in the Netherlands.
Yes, because the ABC, we couldn't afford tulips, so we got these old wooden shoes. Yes, that's a Dutch story, obviously a Dutch story.
Involving the autobahns.
They're having a lot of trouble speeding in Holland, because it's flat. There's no hills. You can speed like... You hear the Holland kids. Come to Holland, speeding capital of Europe! And so if you... are they going to let sheep on the freeway... to try and slow people down.
A sheep hump, that's right.
That's a sheep hump, which is a New Zealand invention.
4 points for you. See, and you only get 5 points to win.
And you get five?
Yeah, you get five.
Oh, can it?
Well, you can tie and then I'll get
with
you
with the
anyway.
Virgin Mary, we can get anything.
How do you know this isn't a virgin sheep?
You've been handling it.
Like I'm Mr. Brady at the moment, trying to keep the kids at home. Authorities in a Holland city reasoned that speeding cars endangered small children, and sheep had about as much sense as a six-year-old. So why not let a few ewes wander through the rush hour traffic and force drivers to slow down? But if they really want to slow the traffic, they should give the sheep hats and put them in Volvos.
Look, Paul, I got the whole sheep into the wooden shoe.
Everyone's good at something.
We
With the ABC cutbacks, I need something to fall back on. And putting woolly sheep in a wooden shoes is a skill for the 90s.
I'm about to have a breakdown.
Watch out for the sheep.
Julie, James and Peter, what strange tale do the Virgin Mary, 10,000 buckets of water and a fractured skull tell?
All right. In these days of competition for scarce government funds, this is our opportunity to prove that we too can be multicultural. We're looking here at an Italian story about a sacred figure and a sacred festival. And yet, a surprising act of almost terrorism by an individual against a little religious festival.
I.e.? They were having this religious festival with the Virgin Mary.
About which we're not going to make
sure. Someone flew over in a helicopter and unloaded all the water, tons and tons of water, in fact, 10,000 buckets equivalent, onto the head of the festive and deeply pious crowd.
And unfortunately, tons of water hit the heads of the faithful festival goers. Bang-o, one of them gets a fractured skull.
Fractured skull.
Fortunately, big VM there, little miracle, everyone's happy in the village. Happy ending.
Hey! You put the skull on the bucket! I put the sheep in the shoe!
Ah, we work as a team.
3 points for you. Italian police are searching for the pilot of a firefighting plane that dropped 5 tons of water onto a ceremony blessing an underwater statue of the Virgin Mary. The worshippers didn't get out of the way after the first pass because when someone said there was a second coming, they were expecting Jesus. Mikey Robbins, Helen Razer and Tony Squires have finished with a very proud and noble 12 points. Just edging out the formidable Julie McCrossan, James O'Loughlin, Peter Berner on 10 points. So we say thank you to both teams and leave you with the good news that on her trip to Maralinga, Fergie will live in a traditional Aboriginal shelter with a man who lost both legs to radiation poisoning. She'll be deprived of all home comforts and surrounded by snakes, scorpions and dingoes. I can just see the New Idea headline now. Grumpy, jumpy, frumpy shares dumpy humpy with Stumpy. And let's all just hope there isn't any rumpy pumpy. Good night. It's good news. We